I think the key disruption right now is just the shifting of consumer behavior from content, from moving from a linear TV viewing experience to an on-demand. And so that really disrupts your ability to program out an evening, and really the power of programming has shifted away from the traditional network programmer to the consumer. It's challenging because you can't pivot completely without abandoning your core. Our core still is very much an older audience that is still watching TV linear, but we have a new group that is growing up in a non-linear fashion. So we have to support that core business and then move to this new business. And we've done that through a lot of digital distribution products. So we're on every platform, be it Apple, Roku, Chromecast, you name it. And we do it both for kids and for general audience. So we actually have two apps across all those platforms. And then we also do it with a product called the Passport. And Passport is a member benefit that if you're a member of your local station, you get access to a digital library of all the PBS content. So for that younger audience who wants to watch on their own schedule, they can do that and support their station. So it's kind of twisting that pledge model, you might recall, you know, here's our pledge drive, please contribute, but if people aren't watching linear TV, they're missing that message. So you're taking that message, putting it into an on-demand world and through Passport. And it's working very, very well. You have seen other cable companies come and go who have tried to go into a genre of ours, be it history or arts or education, and they all go back into reality TV at the end of the day. And it's not quality programming like we have. I would love data to drive our marketing decisions much more than we do. And that's really just because of how difficult it is right now to gather data across all these different platforms. And again, especially in our case, we're dealing with different audiences. I have a very loyal core audience that is over-the-air traditional linear TV. And I have a new audience that isn't. And I'm going to have to reach them differently. The kids' content is proven through independent studies to actually help children be prepared and be ready to learn for kindergarten or first grade. And of course it's commercial free, but it's actually helping the kids. And we do this in a multi-platform way, so there's also games as well. And the games are not just a smashing game. There's actually educational core curriculum tied to the curriculum in the video, and it reinforces that key learning. And I think our differentiation, whether it starts with the kids all the way up to adult, is about lifelong learning. So, you know, right now we have super cats on nature, and you're learning about all the different cats out in the wild. Or just recently we did The Great American Read, counting down America's most loved books. And, you know, I don't know any other company that was spent, you know, a few months on books on TV. A year ago or so, we launched a kids 24-hour, 7 days a week channel, a multicast channel, and we did it both in traditional over-the-air as well as in digital. And it really is meeting, again, both worlds. There's what is known as the digital divide. Believe it or not, there's lots of kids in America who don't have cable, who don't have broadband. And that second TV in the home might not be hooked up to a cable box. Often, they were watching content in the evening when we weren't on the air with quality children's educational shows. We launched to meet that need, and now, you know, it is, and it's a very rewarding to feel, to understand that, you know, we're helping kids and underserved communities.